Javed Saab, do you think that the PTI workers have felt let down by the decision of their leader? But do you think that that's the right approach of the workers to be taking? Because clearly, it's some people are also saying that that is a victory for Mr. Imran Khan, that the Supreme Court has now taken up the matter and the TORs are going to be discussed and so forth. What do you think is the real problem with the PTI worker?
I think the bigger issue that PTI worker have faced, that is a little different. I mean, what my colleague has pointed out, that's also a fact. But they wanted to see Imran Khan among them. That did not happen. He stayed inside his residence where practically he was house arrested, and workers were expecting he should have come out. And I think some sort of concerns were also made by Sheikh Rashid. They wanted some sort of action replay of what they saw in Rawalpindi when Sheikh Rashid came out on the roads despite police crackdowns, despite heavy tear gassing. That did not happen. I think that's the main point. Then we should not forget that Imran Khan was focusing on two points, that if Nawaz Sharif, Prime Minister, accept our terms and conditions, terms of reference for setting up an independent judicial commission, we would not go for this dharna. So what happened? There was a in-between situation. The Supreme Court offered its role, which PTI accepted, that we would accept the terms and conditions, terms of reference of judicial commission. And I think they had a face saving, and he has a reason to propagate that part of our demands has been accepted through the Supreme Court. It is a neutral forum, and we are going to end our plan to lock down. And another factor that we are particularly ignoring, and that is the fact that there was a excessive use of force, which was used by the government against PTI workers, particularly coming from the north west of Pakistan. The roads were completely blocked, and there was heavy tear gassing, and there was little room for those PTI workers to penetrate inside Islamabad. Some of them have used informal routes to go to the Banigala, where Imran Khan residence is, and their number was in hundreds. And from Punjab, there was a crackdown. But then again, there was a problem. There was a lack of coordination. Some of their top leadership is already staying along with Imran Khan. They were not there. People were not coming out. And now I think Imran has got some reason to say that part of their demand has been accepted. But he sounds to be very over enthusiastic. I think there are legal wranglings going on. Tomorrow is going to be a very, very important day. Both parties are going to come up with their own terms and conditions, terms of reference. Now we have to see whose terms of reference are going to be accepted. My understanding of the situation is that the Supreme Court is going to pick up some terms of reference from the government side, some from the opposition side, and they are going to set up judicial commission. And I expect that would be acceptable to all parties. Now, again, there are bigger questions. There is no as such hard evidence to prove charges of opposition.
So we'll talk about those aspects later on in the program. What do you think about the TOR issue? You were speaking earlier on it. So what is your view on that?
I think the terms of reference for setting up judicial commission basically is designed to collect evidence.
Yeah, but what are the main issues in coming to an agreed TORs?
That is where the point I want to come about is there are no legal formulations. There is no as such hard evidence to prove charges against Prime Minister and his family. They're on the face of it, in legal language, we call it as a prima facie. The first impression is that there are contradictions of what Prime Minister and Prime Minister's family member has been saying and what we have heard from the Panama leaks. So these terms of references are basically legal formulations, how to go about, how to collect evidence. This all about the properties of the Prime Minister's family in London and elsewhere. When they made that property, from where that money came, the allegation that is coming from the opposition that that particular money has been illegally channeled from Pakistan to outside, and did government pay taxes, and was there legal means to use? Probably that did not happen. Now government's point of view is that they sold their property in Saudi Arabia, and then there are contradictions because some of the government ministers in the past, they have said they have given different date when they purchased that property. Now Prime Minister's son is saying altogether different. on the basis of these points, evidence would be collected by the judicial commission. That is a very, very important. If somebody is expecting that the Supreme Court within days or weeks is going to come up with a ruling, that is not going to happen. Yes, there is a disqualification case that is a separate to that.
And oh, are you talking about the one that's in the ECP, the Election Commission, where the references have been filed against
Sheikh, that is altogether different case. That,
moving on, sir, is the Supreme Court's decision, in your opinion, Rana Saab, do you think that it is a victory for the PTI, as the PTI has been claiming, although Mr. Chaudhry Nisar has said that there are no winners or losers in this particular case? But let's talk about the Day of Thanksgiving, which is being celebrated by the PTI. What's behind the motivation of realizing it as a victory?
You see, there are reasons. PTI probably realized that they have not been able to gather as much crowd as they were expecting, and particularly at a time when the government used a very excessive use of force. Let's accept as the facts stand on the ground. The workers did not come out from their homes. Partly the reason that Imran Khan himself opted to stay indoor, and partly because there was least coordination. The top leadership was already there. But overall, I would say that Imran Khan can propagate. It's a sort of face saving. But we have to see a bigger picture. The bigger picture was the situation could have gone out of control. There is no casualty, few injuries, luckily. What if they would have managed to come inside Islamabad? There are few deaths, and already government doesn't have a good relation with the military establishment. I think it would have given more space to the undemocratic forces to pressurize the government. It is a victory for the government to the extent that they have averted an ultimate crisis where the Prime Minister could have been pressurized to resign. Frankly speaking, that kind of situation was developing. So it is a great relief for the government. For Imran Khan, he was making this claim that my terms and conditions should be accepted. Those have not been accepted altogether. But let's see what happened tomorrow. Because tomorrow is going to be the test of the Supreme Court. Whose terms of reference are going to be accepted? Whose are going to be rejected? My understanding of the situation is they'll take terms of reference from the both sides, but most of them may be from the opposition side. Given the fact that I think this is not appropriate that when we bracket Prime Minister with everybody else, he is a Prime Minister, he has to be above the board. This impression should not exist that the Prime Minister in one way or the other trying to make it a lengthy process so that nobody could hold him responsible. We know Prime Minister is not directly involved, but certainly there are assumptions, there are suspicions that the money was channeled from Pakistan, and there has to be evidence which the investigators should collect, or Prime Minister himself should come up, show to everybody that this is the tax I have paid, these are the channels I have used this money to build up my properties in London and elsewhere. And more importantly, I think there are genuine legal questions when those flats were purchased. Was it in early 90s? If that is the case, the property was sold in 2005. So I think these conflicting statements that have emerged from the family members of the Prime Minister, those needs to be legally have some sort of correspondent, some sort of evidence has to be collected.
Right.
And that is where I think the role of Judicial Commission is going to be determined.
Right. What's your opinion, what's your view of this comments by various political parties about the U-turn and the surrender? And some, I mean, are obviously is not taking that view. They're saying that, you know, it is a victory for democracy and the democratic process and the system. I think that's a much better way to look at the situation rather than put the PTI down when they're down already.
I think it is not as such U-turn. You see, what we were looking for, there should have been a gathering of 1 million people or 100,000, and they would have locked down Islamabad, and the military would have come in, would have pressurized the Prime Minister, and he would have been removed. That situation did not happen. I think there's a very silver lining in it, in the Supreme Court's offer. He was saying all along that I want an independent, genuinely independent judicial commission. He reposed his trust in the Supreme Court. And the Supreme Court said, we are going to set up judicial commission. We'll take proposals from both sides and will make it. I think it is a general face saving. It is not a U-turn. A U-turn would have been that he would say, no, well, he wasn't saying that I don't going to accept any judicial commission in any form, even from the Supreme Court. He never said that. So I think it is, frankly speaking, not a U-turn. It gives him a room where he can politically manipulate, politically propagate, can tell his workers that there is a success. Though I don't believe the success is as the way he's reporting, it is not the case. But certainly it gives him a face saving. But I think we have to understand, just 2-3 days back, there was a situation, a very slight constitutional crisis had already started. It started when the PTI said it would not accept Islamabad High Court's judgment.
Yes, bigger problem.
That's the bigger point. Yeah. When mainstream opposition party is saying that we are going to go for a shutdown of Islamabad, we are not going to hold a peaceful rally, they were silent. They have been making it public that they are going to block Islamabad.
Right.
So you see, that means the mainstream opposition party is not accepting the writ of the constitution and the writ of the government, and they accepted it only when they saw there is a huge crackdown, heavy crackdown. They can't penetrate inside Islamabad. Then they were saying the High Court's judgment is being violated. Yes, the High Court's judgment was violated by the government by launching a crackdown. And probably the government was left with a little option because they didn't want the blockage of the capital Islamabad.
Absolutely.
That was completely.
I think the PTI had pushed the government against the wall.
So the point I'm trying to make is that constitutional crisis which had started, that has been averted.
Yeah, which is
and
good.
If we say it is a partial success of Imran Khan, it's a fact. If we say it is a relief for the government, hugely it is a success because the third force, now there is a little room for them to pressurize Prime Minister.
Right.
So it is a success. Anybody can say it is a success. But when you talk of the other opposition parties, that we have to also understand that there are allegations and there is a clear perception about People's Party that in fact it is in league with the ruling party because the corruption charges against People's Party
are far more strong. Well, the People's Party claims the otherwise.